Welcome. Thank you for lending an ear to the Voice of the Times for Friday, August 6, 2021. For today's editorial, ASEAN and its South China Sea Dilemma. Meeting in an online conference earlier this week, foreign ministers of Japan and the Association of Southeast Asian Nations, or ASEAN, stressed the importance of freedom of navigation in the South China Sea. Japanese Foreign Minister Toshimitsu Motegi underscored his country's opposition to the use of force to change the status quo in the Indo-Pacific region. Motegi did not mention China, but the allusion was transparent enough. Beijing has long been locked in disputes with nations in the region that have been pushing back against its increasingly aggressive efforts to fortify its claim to practically the entire South China Sea. Several member countries of ASEAN, including the Philippines, are trying their best to protect their territory from Chinese intrusions. Japan is not the first major power to assert the freedom of navigation in the South China Sea. The United States has for years been sending its warships to the contested waters on what it calls, quote, freedom of navigation operations, or FONOPs. A British fleet led by the aircraft carrier Queen Elizabeth recently capped a 42,000-kilometer voyage by crossing the South China Sea. And Germany has sent a frigate to sail into the disputed sea region. The first time in almost 20 years a German warship has gone on a mission almost halfway across the world. Japan, however, is the first to engage directly with the regional association in mapping a strategy to keep the world's second busiest waterway free from unilateral restrictions. China is naturally alarmed by the increasing passages through the South China Sea and has warned that naval vessels sailing too close to the atolls, reefs, and artificial islands it claims as its own will be challenged. As one Chinese senior military officer put it rather colorfully, quote, "This is our backyard. We can decide what vegetables or flowers we want to grow." Beijing insists the freedom of passage applies only to commercial and passenger shipping, not to warships. The U.S., however, is not calling Beijing's bluff and has been ramping up its freedom of navigation operations in the South China Sea. For a mere 3 operations in 2015, 9 operations were conducted in 2020. Projecting a military presence in the Asia-Pacific has been one of pillars of the U.S. pivot to Asia geopolitical design. Washington felt it was time to confront the growing influence of China in this part of the world, which is being touted as the next economic global hub. Asia is where the action will be in the decades to come, and the U.S. definitely does not want to be left out. As Defense Secretary Mark Esper boldly proclaimed, quote, "The Indo-Pacific is the epicenter of a great power competition with China." The waters of the 3.5 million square kilometer South China Sea hold oil reserves believed to be as much as 28 billion barrels and 266 trillion cubic feet of natural gas. There are also reports that it has deposits of rare earth metals that are crucial in the manufacture of electronic devices like smartphones, components for electric vehicles, and even parts of military defense systems. China needs these natural resources to help power its ambitions of becoming the world's biggest superpower. That raises the stakes even higher. The South China Sea could be the next front line in a new Cold War. ASEAN must avoid getting swept up in such an international confrontation. China is its neighbor, and its actions will always ripple across the region. The U.S. and its allies can be supportive, but when push comes to shove, their own interests will come first. Right now, ASEAN's focus must be to act as one cohesive group in deciding the path to take. Its main strength lies in its solidarity. Singapore Prime Minister Lee Hsien Loong was on point when he said the Southeast Asian region stands, quote, "at the intersection of the interest of various major powers and must avoid being caught in the middle or forced into invidious choices." It is a game of geopolitical chess, and ASEAN must plan its moves prudently. And that's the editorial for August 6, 2021. For more news and information, get a copy of the Manila Times on print. Subscribe to its digital edition or log on to www.manilatimes.net. Follow us on Twitter, Facebook, or Instagram. And listen to the Voice of the Times.